Hey, what's up guys, this is Daddy Cool, and you are watching Satisfactory with the subtitle Megafactory Online. Now in previous episode there are two major things that happened. One of them is I have put online these free assemblers in the background and they are producing now modular frames, which is the end product of this whole area, production area, which we have here. And this is one of the things I have done, and the other one is that there is a coal source, a relative good coal source in here, I mean two of them, and I have created electricity production based on that resource into here. So from now on electricity is more or less solved for this whole factory area. The goal of this episode is to fulfill the requirements for phase 2 of the space elevator. I mean, I don't think I will produce all of the necessary resources by the end of this episode, but at least I will set up everything to have proper production things there. The other thing is just to notice here is that this area is not producing anything. And the reason for that is that I have guided this iron ore resource feeding system into this area, and it's feeding my production site here, and this conveyor belt is empty. But the good thing is that I have two iron sources in there in the background, and I can upgrade them, so the excess iron ore which is not used by the existing lines gonna be directed there, and this will set things here back online. This is not a very efficient production area in this this land, but it's good that it's producing something while I am planning and doing things in the background. So let's just do this. I'm gonna hop there to the iron mines, and I have actually both of them producing iron ingots, right? So this one is producing iron ingots and the other one is doing the same. So what I'm gonna do now here, I'm gonna replace this one the upgraded version, also upgrade the conveyor belt for the better efficiency, and I'm gonna direct, oh it's not good here, the burner, but it's already not needed anymore, so I'm gonna direct the rest of the iron ore here. I have to climb up. Yeah. Come on. Okay. So the iron ore from this miner is going into this splitter. Actually, I can direct the resources from there up to here and put that in line like that. I think I have some iron ore on hand, yeah, let's just feed it there. So this means this iron ore resource is free to use. That's not what I wanted. It was, yeah, because I wanted to direct, well, basically it's what I wanted. So the direction was okay, let's give it some power. Now it's mining, and I'm gonna direct the end product to the point where the other one was cancelled. Here. This one is the old conveyor belt, which is not in use anymore. So let's direct this one into here. And production in that area which I just mentioned previously is resumed. I'm gonna harvest this. So basically it's functional once again. I'm gonna go upstairs a little bit to collect some stuff. Maybe I'm also gonna collect the rotors from here. Yeah. That's an end product. I still have free inventory space. Let's go up in here. And I wanna collect some concrete because actually there is no other place at the moment where I can gather that, but I'm producing a surplus, so that's okay if I just empty that machine. Let's take a couple of those, maybe a couple of those just in case, and I'm gonna take these as well. Let's sort things out. Very good. So basically that's more or less okay. I'm gonna put a couple of things into the hub and we can go to construct the phase 2 requirements very shortly. So put this there, that one in there. What else? I do not have anything else unnecessary on hand. That's okay. So hop into here. And I am planning to go to that farther lookout tower because from that point I will be able to see everything. I mean this left hand side area. That's the place where I am planning to put the things. Okay, so let's do this. Like that. Okay. In this side. That's gonna be enough for now. As you can see, concrete is the low on quantity. I'm not even gonna build that. I wanna have concrete in hand. Maybe a little bit later we will collect some more. So that's the area, that's the building area. Let's do some stuff. So let's check now what to do. Not that. I wanna create the assemblers. Placed into here. Maybe like that. And let's just put a couple of those in there. It's much easier if you have enough resources on hand. Come on, just one more piece there. No, it's not gonna work, but we will find out how many I still want to place. So I wanna create the versatile framework into here because the modular frames are produced behind my back and I also have some steel beams producing there. And the output is 5 units per minute, which means if I wanna create 10 units per minute, that's gonna be okay. Let's put this thing online. Oops, wrong direction once again. Conveyor lift here. I just can't believe this. Conveyor lift facing there. There you go. That other one is like that. Put a splitter into here, leading from the back. Connect those. That's okay. Now I would like to place a splitter here, feeding from my direction. There you go, one. And that's the other one. Okay. Conveyor belts go there. And last one. Now I should be putting these modular frames deconstructed here. Let's put a splitter into here. Yeah, resources coming from the back. That's good. There you go. Also done. And I think I'm just gonna feed it there. So normally this will solve the feeding of these machines with modular frames. And the requirement is 5 modular frames per minute for the two machines. And my output is actually 6 pieces per minute for the 3 machines. So this means I will still create some surplus in here. But let's just not leave these machines without material. I'm gonna put them manually into there just for now. Yeah, that's okay. And I will need iron rod also. And the current consumption of iron rods is 36 units per minute. And these one require nothing, only steel beams. Okay, then let's just add the steel beams by hand, probably. That's gonna be the next thing, and normally they should be producing once I give them power. So I will have to lead the steel beam products into here, so that these machines are working properly. That's gonna be the next step once I have placed these things here into system. Yeah, so now they should be working. I mean, why are you not producing anything? No power. Oh yeah. Now they have power. And they are producing. Okay, finished product position. I'm gonna put storage here. Yeah, that's great. Merger comes into here. So that's the direction of finished product. Just like that. Okay, here we go. There you go. And there you go. So this line is more or less okay. I mean, I'm missing something, but still, yeah, it's already producing the requirements, and I have to give them the system steel beams, which I have to get from the other side. But before that, let's check the other machinery here. So you're gonna produce the smart plating and reinforced iron plates, and rotors are the requirements. So it's 3, and I wanna create 10 pieces, so I still can put here 2 more assemblers. Like that, and that. Okay, smart plating and smart plating. While I am in this back area, let's just put a couple of things here so that they are also functioning. Yeah, electricity there, connect. electricity, connect, electricity, connect, electricity, and yeah, that's it. So they are online. I'm gonna collect the produce things in this side, so it's gonna be a merger. Yeah, going this way, that's okay. Did I put it so close? That's strange. Yeah, they are in line. So, once again, merger. There we go. And that was the last one. So let's put this there. There. And normally this should be okay. Yeah, I felt that something is not correct in here. Where are you? Oh, it's a merger, so I only need to know the output. There we are. Okay, so now finished products will go into one place. And it's gonna be a storage container in here, like that. Okay, there. So that one is solved. Now, the fading is rotors and reinforced iron plates, and unfortunately, I do not have rotor production just set up yet, but reinforced iron plate is the thing I have, so I will now create the feeding for the reinforced iron plates. Yeah, there we go. And the fifth. Okay, it's gonna be feeded by splitters. It's the same position for all of them. And just connect everything together into one line. Okay, now here are the reinforced iron plates. Let's put a splitter into here. Feeding from that direction, that's okay. Now it's in position. And if I done things right, that should be connecting together. Yeah, they do. Good. And the basic idea is, let's just get these out. The basic idea is that I am producing 20 pieces of reinforced iron plates on these machines, and the modular frame production requires 9 pieces of reinforced iron plates, and the versalite frames, I mean those, are required 10 pieces, so I have one piece extra during production, but I will feed now all of these machines by hand for the required quantity, I mean up to 100 pieces, so that the modular frame production is not stopping just yet, because the system requires some time to fill up. So that's okay. And the next step is to put splitters here. And they will feed the rotors, which I do not have yet, but that's not gonna be a problem now. I do not really need the last one to be on exact location. Yeah, because this one I can just connect like that. There we go. Okay, it's gonna be a splitter once again. Oh, it's really hard to position properly. Are we okay? I mean, normally we should be okay like this. Yeah. That's good. Let's put one more. There you go, another splitter. There. Yeah, like that. And one more goes in there. Yeah, and that's the last one. Connect that one there. There. That one goes there. And that one goes there. Now I'm gonna put conveyor belt of this like here. And now everything is prepared for production. So the next thing I would like to do is I wanna split the rotors into two, and I wanna put these into there because I want these machines to function while I am preparing the other part of the necessities, I mean the rotor production. So normally they are now producing the smart platings. That's good. Okay, this segment is more or less ready. Yeah, we are. We have a couple of those things also. And steel beams are empty from hand. I'm gonna just think over what's the next thing I should be doing. So that's okay. So let's just do a little bit of math here. What I'm still missing to make this line efficient. These machines require rotors as an input, but they are more or less fitted with the rotors, just the ones that I had in stock. So that can wait a little bit. These two require steel beams, and that's a little bit bigger problem because at the moment my steel production at that area are transferring the products into something else. Well, basically I can direct the finished steel products into here, but probably that's not gonna be enough because the constructors creating steel ingots into steel beams with a ratio of 3:1, so 60 pieces of steel ingots turn into 15 pieces of steel beams, and these two machines require 60 pieces of steel beams, so that translates into 120 pieces of ingots, which translates into 120 pieces of iron ore and coal just to feed these two. So that has to be solved, and it's also a setup, so I will create a blueprint for steel production. But before that, just before that, I would like to do some building in here. So let's do this just really fast. Come on, There you go. So I want to put an assembler into here with facing to that direction. That's okay. Like this. Yep. And I want to create here automated wiring, and for that it requires setters. I have in hand, that's good, and 50 units of cable per minute. So that thing is something else that has to be feed it here, and the end product, I think that this machine can handle it, because it's only 100 pieces that I require, and yeah, I have put 100 pieces of stators there, so that's not gonna be a problem. And the thing is, I am feeding the cables into here, so we're gonna change this. Now it's MK1, right? Okay, so that's gonna be the source into there. The spaghetti building is growing. I mean, there are more and more spaghetti lines, but yeah, actually some of them are being eliminated from time to time, so it's still not that brutal. There you go. So cable is feeded into here, stators are in the line, and automated wiring is being produced there. I'm gonna put maybe one storage container here for the finished product. There we go. And normally this should be working well. Okay, cables are coming, that's good. So and yeah, one more thing, because before I do the blueprints, I'm gonna collect some concrete, because that's still very low on quantity, and I made a little bit of calculation, and I need plenty of cables for that automated wiring, so the rest of the cables will come with me, and I'm gonna put them into the machine as well. Let's do this hopping. Okay, so I need the concrete, I will need the modular frames, even the steel beams can come, yeah, from here too, and modular frames which I need, maybe some reinforced iron plates. So I'm gathering basically everything to be able to create the blueprint. Yeah, let's just collect things from here. So here are a couple of rotors, that's good. I think this container is empty, yeah. Oh, lot of reinforced iron plates, that's good. I can put some rods in there, and maybe some rod into there. It's also fine. Let's check the things here. Couple of modular frames, wonderful. And climb up, gather the rest of the modular frames from the storage, if there is any, of course. Put the cables in the machine, and after that, time to create a new blueprint. Hop here, hop there, here we go, gather those, and put the cables here, that's good. Now you should be, what's the problem? No power. Oh, it's good that I visited this place once more. Okay, now it's working. So, creating the blueprint. I know you like the music behind the creation. So let's hear that music once more, and I'm gonna create a new steel production. Here we go. Welcome back. The blueprint is ready. Well, the good thing is that now I could build it. The bad thing is I need plenty of resources to just run that faction and that area. And actually I'm lacking concrete. So I have turned the only machine down which is using concrete as a resource. And my inventory is also full a little bit, so let's just put these things into this machine. And now I can go for the next objective. I have to gather coal and iron resource, and both of them should be 240 pieces to feed the steel production that I am planning to put down. And the good thing is that we have something in here. I mean, here are two conveyor belts that are delivering only coal. And the right hand side has 120 pieces at the moment, and the left hand side has 60 pieces per minute. Because these are three normal coal sources. All of them have MK1 miners, but I can upgrade them, all of the three, and this will result double quantity. So this 60 will turn into 120, and the 120 will turn into 240 pieces per minute, and that's what I'm looking for, because I will direct this conveyor belt instead of the other one, which will feed the production in the very first temporary base, and the rest of the 240 pieces will be directed to the new steel production that I'm planning to locate, to build. So this means coal problem will be solved. I just have to upgrade these conveyor belts so that they are delivering the proper quantity. Yep, like that. is also gonna be upgraded. Yeah. That's good. And let's upgrade this one as well. Now, I think all of the free lines are upgraded up to this point. And I would like to attach this as a zero. Okay, so hopefully now you will see just everything upgraded very fast. And actually only my fingers are dancing on the keyboard, but it's okay. Oops, didn't want to fall down. So that's the plan actually. There you go. Yeah, it's working. Nice. Now everything is upgraded up to this point. And according to my calculations, I cannot keep this smelter running anymore. I have to deconstruct things here. I mean, I do not have to, but I want to. So that one is eliminated like that. And I'm gonna deconstruct this segment here, because that's gonna be replaced for the other one. So now the upper area is still gonna be going with the coal coming from here, and the rest of the coal, which are 240 pieces per minute, will be directed to the location I am planning to place the steel production on a bigger scale. Yeah. Let's put it here. Is it overlapping? Yeah, of course, why not? So let's just hop things here like that. No, only one layer. Yeah, coal goes there, and now it can go down here to the slope. Yeah, perfect. Let's can I go underneath? No. Let's create one more thing here. Deconstruct. Deconstruct that. Yeah. There we go. And I'm gonna lead it somewhere into here. Let's see the position. I will decide later how to go forward with that. So it's gonna be a crisscross again. Yeah, a big bowl of spaghetti is going on, but I cannot do anything about it right now. So let's check the iron resource, because that one is not solved yet. There we go. That's a good find. It's actually there. Okay, so that's a pure iron resource, and this means it's 240 pieces per minute if I put an MK2 miner on that, which I was just looking for. Yeah, that's very good. So let's put the production MK2 miner in here. Output coming this way. You receive some electricity there. And deliver resources to this. that's okay. Let's go in here. I want to go over it. Yep, that. Coming into here. And I suppose that's gonna be the end of this line. Now, I have coal, I have iron, everything is here. That electricity pole will be not on a good spot. Let's just replace it. Yeah. And just to be able to build things, I have to gather some concrete. And that's the way I'm heading to now. And I think, I mean, the concrete will be more or less enough for a short period of time. So I will turn the production on once again, which uses the concrete. Oh, everything is crisscrossing here too. Not really the way I like it. So, sooner or later this will be solved. 360 in there, that's okay. The conveyor belt is full, that's also very nice. So if I turn the machine on, it will be filled up, and once again the container will collect the resources for me, because I'm still producing surplus from the concrete. Let's take these, sort things out here. What else may I need? Maybe some rotors, because rotor production is not going yet. Do I have pipes? Let's just take some pipes. Yeah, like that. And the rotors are the last things before I finish that steel production. Come on, come on, come on. There you go. Rotors picked up. That's good. Oh, come on. Now it's okay. I might pick up a couple of reinforced iron plates. Yeah, let's just take them with me. And these one will be bought to the space elevator a little bit later. Have here just like those, and here, wow, okay, modular frames in hand, that's very good. And now I am in position, let's create that steel factory. So let's just build a foundation first, that's gonna be the first step. There you go, there you go. There you go, and there you go. That's good. Now, I don't like that edge there. Make it like this. Okay, blueprint. Now steel beam production, And how should I position this? Maybe like this. And the other one. Like that. Okay. Do production systems online in here. And I have to solve feeding of this, but these are the feeding points. I mean these two. So this means I'm gonna put a splitter into here. Feeding from the back side. It's okay. Let's put two on each other. Like that. Okay, you go there and you go in there, and this one goes there, and the upper one goes into here. Come on, what's the problem? Yeah, now it's okay. And we're gonna feed it from this position. Like that. And that one. Like that. Okay. Now. Let's just connect these things together. There you go. Just too far away, but that's okay. There we go. This one goes like that and like that. Now, this has solved the steel production problem from input size. I mean, input side and. Now let's do something about the output area. I mean it's here, right? Yeah. I think I'm gonna just change this to the other direction. It's easier. So it's gonna be a merger. Yeah, and direction is this. That's not good in here. It's also not good in here. And I do not hear the machines working because they are not online. But this is gonna be solved now. So it was merger. Yeah, one and two. And let's put the faster conveyor belt there. And there. And the currently fastest one in there. So, I'm gonna put another merger into here. They are not aligned, but not a problem. There you go. There. There. And that's gonna be conveyor belt like this. Because I have to bring all of this stuff into somewhere there in the front. So let's build this one. Not good. I have to give a point for that. It's gonna be a splitter. So that one into there, that's good. And now, where is the feeding point? There we go. It's not possible like that. How should I do this? Let's put a splitter like that. That's okay. One of the points done. And I am missing the steel beams. It's good that I have steel beam production. There you go, a couple of steel beams. Come on, I cannot jump up here. Okay, and you can be connected there. And now, yeah, everything is going, producing, flowing. Very good. Let's just check how things are working here. Everything is green. That's good. So steel beam production is on the line. It's feeding into there. Modular frames are going also into here. These are producing the things into here. That's good. These five are producing the things into that container. Also good. So I am only missing the rotors, and that's the next step. So rotor production, and I will place probably into this area those rotors. And let's just check how many concrete do I have. Of course I do not have enough. I could place that one more layer there, but I have to place screw factories and other things too. And I might not even have enough space for here just now, and I'm also lacking the concrete. So probably it's a good idea to think this over. And I have a good idea, I think. I mean, on the ground floor in the other area we have production machines, right? And they are using iron ore resource, I mean 120 iron ore actually, which are turned into iron ingots in there, and they are producing something, but actually not anything that is not produced in here. So I can just get rid of those of that ground area and deconstruct it, and I can place the screw factories there and also the iron dot factory there, and I can transport everything here for the rotor production. Yeah, that seems to be a good solution for the current problems. So I'm gonna deconstruct these foundations just for now to get back some concrete, and I'm gonna prepare the rotor production here, which will be three assemblers, actually not constructors, assemblers. Yeah, and I need some space here, so let's just put it like this. Come on. Yeah, like that. Okay, and let's put it as a free. So this is gonna be a rotor production, this one also, and this one also. So it requires iron rods and screws. Iron rod 60 pieces, that's okay, and screw 300 pieces, which actually is gonna be a little bit of a problem. It requires 30 iron ores and 120 screws for 300 pieces. I cannot feed it with iron ore enough. I mean, I have 120 iron ores there, and two screw production blueprints will require 60, and the iron rod also 60. This will result 60 iron rods and 240 screws, and I need 300, but actually this would result 12 pieces of rotors, and those machines require only 10 pieces altogether. It's 5 machines and 2 per minute, so it's only 10. So probably this is more or less good. I think let's do it. Yeah, that's the good idea. Let's put conveyor lift MK3 there. That's gonna be the screw. Do I need even MK3? I don't think so. 100 pieces goes for MK2, right? Yeah. So this is the screw feeding. Put a splitter here and resources will come. Well, good question. Let's receive them from that side. And it's screws, so I have to put the fastest feeding system possible. Yeah, I can only deliver 240 pieces at maximum, so 300 pieces would cause me problems just yet in either way. So let's put a merger here. No, it's gonna be a splitter. Okay, feeding is the same. Yeah, it's also good. And this one, it's once again good. So iron rods is only 60 pieces, so the simple conveyor belt is just enough here. Okay, so this one is prepared for the incoming of goods. Yeah, that's good. And output, let's put a couple of mergers here. And we are going that way with the finished product. Yeah. So rotors are not a big quantity, so MK1 delivery system is just fine. Okay, and I am only missing electricity, which I did not give to this whole area. Let's just do this really fast. And I have set the production right. So electricity goes there and there, and you go into, where is the next one? Oh, it's here. Yeah, that one goes there, and connection to the system, very good. Now I only have to lead the rotors into the other area. Like this, you come to here, and this one, oh yeah, here. And I think it was planned to be come to here. No, not here. No, it's the iron plate. Come on, where is the point? Oh, it's here up. Okay. I knew I was planning it. Okay, so I think basically that's all for today, guys. Just cannot go through there. So this is the end of this episode. I hope you enjoy the content, and if you just like, please hit the like button or even the subscribe, but it's really up to you. And we will start the next episode by demolishing this whole area and building up something similar like I have in here. Wow, that was a good fall. Okay, see you next time. Goodbye.